Hello everybody, we started by talking about my hairlessness and your hair fullness, which is a little like saddy for me, Keisha. So I wanted to open this discussion by asking all of you, what is the purpose of communication?
Yes, so the purpose of communication is to like communicate your thoughts.
Very nicely articulated. What does it mean to speak? What are the skills or qualities do you need? Okay, so I've got Vihan who has raised his hand. Yeah, Vihan.
Yeah, so when you're like speaking or conveying a message, so you should have fluency.
So I'm just going to use voice modulation as the key word here, and I'm going to put these words. So Kian, say if I come to your class and I say, "Hi students." Am I speaking for effect, Kian?
No, you are not speaking for effect. Like, you are so lazy, kind of thing. Like, hi, hello. So we have to say it properly. Like, hi, hello.
Excellent. Yeah. And whoever I cold call will read the quote that I have selected. Then others can raise their hand and they can explain what they understand from that particular quote.
Yes, the first sentence, which is raise your words, not voice, means try to explain, not try to shout at somebody.
We have to use words in such a way which do not hurt people and create an argument.
Yeah, so for the hard argument, I think it also means a lot of facts and evidence you give.
You know, one person might say, hey, listen, give me your pencil now. I forgot to bring mine. And the other one says, can you please give me the pencil? I don't want to get scolded, please. Who are you more likely to give the pencil to? Zara?
Second one. As you gave an example that it really touches to our heart and it is like our mindset changes that, yeah, this is a so nice person, so let me help him.
Okay. There is a blind person sitting on the side of a street. Now, you can put one of these two boards beside this blind person, blind old beggar. You can either use the first one or the second one. So, Om, what you'll have to do is read both of these boards for us, and then tell us which one would you pick and why.
So you can see and the other person doesn't, so it makes you feel like you should give because you have the right to do it. You have the privilege to see.
It's a privilege to see. So what you are telling me also is that when using your words can also be a privilege. Just like seeing is a privilege, using words is also a privilege. And therefore, you know, you have to balance both. You have to be mindful of the choice of words also that you have. Now, my question is, oh my God, I hate this. Which image describes this particular statement? Yeah, Ishi.
I think the first one is more for the ew kind of feeling, that ew, and it's kind of like it maybe smells really dirty or something like that. But I think the fourth one, because I hate this, you get that frustration kind of face, that ugh, I hate this, like that. That's why I think it's the fourth one.
You could use the word hate when I dislike the thing more than dislike. So there I would use the word hate.
That's true. But what's the purpose of this building? Is this building a school? If it's not a school, then what is it? Look at the cues that you have. All right. So you have got bars everywhere, all the way.
I think it's a jail.
I see. Is it a jail or is it a correctional facility?
Discussing words like detest and dislike and hate. I think that jail, when you use the word jail, it would be if you murdered someone or something like that. Correctional facility seems more better.
Considering all of these, what are the things that you need? What is it? What qualities do you need to be able to speak for effect?
So
Because have you heard the saying that an eye for an eye will make the whole world blind? Have you heard that saying?
Or fighting fire with fire.
When you are upset with someone, you need to communicate that you are upset. That's all. If you go on to also hurt the other person because you are hurt, then where is your humanity exactly? You will get that confidence by using
practicing
and data and facts.
Absolutely. You will have the confidence by practicing with data, facts, and evidences.